Hey, thanks for checking out the video. If you've been following along, you know that Wally has been acting up. So I had a couple of solutions in my last video, and I'm going to try to implement some of them here. First thing I'm going to do is this RTK station is, I guess, a little too close to my trees or my pool cage, so I'm going to move that, and I'm also going to move the charging station. So this is a 4x4 post that I put in for my hose a couple weeks ago, and I'm just going to mount the OEM or the pole that came with the system to the top of that, and that should give me the height higher than any of the house mounts that Mowmotion offers. So I got right to it and I 3D printed a simple mounting bracket. I think this is maybe the first version that I printed. The second one, I know I did the countersunk holes, and I also relieved the edges on the bottom of that base. So it's just a little time lapse. I think this may have taken about 10 or 12 hours, but the good thing is I've got this 3D printer set up out in my building, so it just goes at it. And here I'm just removing the RTK from the existing pole. Now, I struggled a little bit with the set screw in the back of my unit. And here I'm just checking the connections, make sure everything's okay. I had to hit that the spring with that adjusting nut with a little bit of WD-40 because it would not loosen up on me. I was nervous. I thought maybe it was cross thread, but that was an easy fix. And so this is the existing pole, and these are the tools that I used: just a standard drill, a Forstner bit, a couple of 3-inch deck screws, and couple of pan head truss bolts with lock washers and nuts. So the first thing I did was I just kind of centered it on there. Yeah, it doesn't have to be that perfect. I marked in the very center with this screwdriver just to put a little dimple on it so I knew where to set my Forstner bit. Now I drilled through as far as I could. It probably went maybe 3 or 4 inches down, and then this way the pole is set into the wood, and then the bracket is just supporting it lightly. So here I'm making sure that everything is lined up, and you can see too, this is the first version of that bracket. It's a little loose around that pole, but I lined it up the best I could and then just ran those 3-inch deck screws into the top of that board. Now with everything secured, I'm just basically running the drill bit to make a mark, and then I'll take it down out of here later and through drill it. And now with everything drilled, I just put those pan head truss, I think it's 1/4-20 thread, with a couple of lock washers, and just to hold it in place. It's always good if you don't have the nylon nuts to use a lock washer. This way it just won't fall out. So I mean, that's a decent height on there, but after a couple of days I came back and checked and there were some fractures. So I went back to the 3D software and I redesigned the bracket, and I also changed the pivot. So before I printed it where it was vertical, and then I changed it about 20 degrees and I added these additional supports. So that really strengthened the bracket a lot. So here, I don't know if you see from that video, but there are actually two fractures, and that's because when it slices, it prints it in layers, and those layers just came apart. So now the layers are running vertically instead of horizontally. I'm just removing that and then adding the new bracket with the same 3-inch deck screws. And like I said, I added those additional supports on both sides, so it hasn't even hinted at cracking yet so far. There it is. In this file, I did put a short out a couple of days ago, YouTube short, and this file is free to download. So if you have a 3D printer and you want to try to do this, by all means, download the file, try it out. So here is a quick time lapse of me cleaning up this area behind this fence. My thought was I was going to relocate the charging station to try to get Luba out of the way. And I have some pavers back there too, so it would stop rolling off the station. So after I cleaned everything up, I moved that charging station over there and then tried to, in the app, relocate the charging station. And if you're thinking of doing this, I hope you're watching this video before you do anything like I do. Because I just unplugged everything and then I moved the RTK, I deleted all my maps, I moved the charging station, it was solid on those pavers. Didn't have to worry about any sinking or anything, but then I could not set that as the charging location because there was weak signal. So I guess it's where the house is, or maybe I have too much with the air conditioning over there. So before you move your charging location in the app, try to see if your Luba has a weak signal. If it does, it's not the best spot for it. So I put the charging station back where it was, and I will level that off in maybe a week or two and put some pavers under it. But for right now, this RTK relocation is working out very well. I had to redo my maps. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to see more, please subscribe. I do have a gate project for the Luba I'm working on to try to get it through a closed gate with a locking mechanism. So that's exciting, and I should have that by the end of this month, hopefully, or at least a prototype. So again, thanks for watching, and please subscribe.